please refer to the user manual for more information about Kreeter's caramelizers. First, spray the bottom, inside walls, mixing blades, and stationary bars in the mixer with Kreeter's nonstick spray. This serves to keep the mixer clean and also helps the caramel corn to separate into individual kernels after being coated. Next, pour the Kreeter's mix into the mixer, making sure that the mixing blades are free of the mix. Then add the water. Refer to the user manuals for the correct amount of water and mix for your specific model and size. Turn on the switch mark heat. Next, turn on the switch mark mixer to briefly mix and evenly spread the caramel corn mix over the bottom of the mixer. Be sure to shut motor switch off when completely mixed. The mix should resemble wet sand. Set the temperature controller on the side of the cabinet between 325 degrees to 375 degrees Fahrenheit according to your recipe. Approximately every 2 minutes, turn mixer on for about 10 seconds. This will allow the caramel mix to cook without sticking. Butter can be added when the temperature is about 25 degrees less than the set point of the controller. The buzzer will sound when the mix reaches the set point and is ready to use. The pilot light and heat would automatically turn off. Caramel coating can be tested for readiness while the caramel is cooking by doing the angel hair test. Dip the corn of the spatula into the kettle and lift up. As the caramel drips off the spatula, small strands of caramel or angel hair will form. Switch off the heat. This will also turn off the buzzer. Turn on the mixer switch. Caution, always remember to turn off the heat switch. At this time, optional ingredients can be added like baking soda and any additional ingredients such as nuts or additional flavorings. Add the popcorn. The mixing baffles will gently mix the popcorn. Refer to the user's manual for the correct amount of popcorn for your specific mixer model and size. Next, spray the corn with 10 squirts of Kreeter's nonstick to separate it into individual kernels and keep it from clumping. Use the spatula to gently press the popcorn into the kettle. When the corn appears to be separated and free in the mixer, which may take up to 2 minutes, turn the mixer motor off and dump the batch into the cooling tray by lifting on the dump handle. Don't run the mixer longer than necessary as it will begin to break up the corn. Use the spatula provided with the machine to reach any hard-to-reach places to completely empty the machine of the caramelized product. gently push the caramel corn around the cooling tray with the spatula to help the product cool faster and break up any clumps that may have formed. After about 8 to 10 minutes, the product will be ready for packaging. When you are ready to make another batch, add the recommended amount of water on the mix instructions and add mix and repeat steps 3 through 12.